This is the classic engine expansion pack for BeamNG. It adds loads of new engine parts and configs to BeamNG's classic American cars, the Barstow, the Blue Buck, and the Moonhawk. With hundreds of new engine parts, you can do anything to these vehicles. As you can see, this is a vanilla engine, and I do think actually the modeling and the texture work on this mod's parts do look a little bit better. Now, this Blue Buck has a small block V8 with a turbocharger. Let's see how it drives. And by the way, this mod is free on the repo by a guy called Javi. So turbocharging cars from the factory didn't really happen a lot in the 1960s in America, but what does this small block V8 feel like with a turbo? Well, accelerating? Oh! Yeah, that's got more power than I thought it would. And you can also hear the sound has been tuned slightly. Listen to this. Just sounds a little bit different. Basically, this mod gives some love to these classic American cars, and it's going to be improved and updated with the future. More cars are coming to this, including the Burnside and the D series, and we'll be checking out the Burnside later. Let's do a quick crash test. Whoa! Oh, the wheel kind of came off. Look at that. The parts menu is where this mod shines. You can see under engine we've got the classic engine pack selected. Now if you open this and we just tune this pretty much infinitely. So we've got the 215. Let's put in the 621 Flying Fox. How big is that? Oh yeah, wow, that's a big engine. We got to change the transmission. I think we're just going to leave it with the 3-speed automatic. And then we can change the overhead valves. We can put race overhead valves. Look, we can even change the bottom end. Early fan, performance electric fan. Wow. You can also actually color the engine by clicking colorable paint and then going to the color menu. Oh yeah, look, this one at the bottom left. Look, we can actually change the color of the engine slightly. We can have a blue engine. Yeah, let's have a blue engine. Why not? What should we do for aspiration? Why not a twin charger? That's a supercharger and a turbo. You can even have an engageable supercharger clutch, and I'll show you what that does. The mod also has customizable body panels, so we can sort out what's going on with the hood here. Let's go for hood type, V8 twin charger hood. Cut twin charger hood. There, look at that. Isn't that epic? And oh my goodness, look at it out there. The twin chargers are huge. Now with that supercharger clutch, we now have a button down here to disengage the supercharger. So what's it like with it disengaged? Still, wow. Still incredibly powerful, and we're getting over torque risk. Oh dear. Okay, so let's engage it. Here we go. This is probably gonna blow up the engine. Here we go. That's even more power. Okay, we need to get to the highway. Cruising along the highway at 60. Let's floor it. Whoa! Oh, the gearbox doesn't know what to do. We're not accelerating because the... Oh, so much wheel spin. Okay, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Whoa, it's very hard to control, but apparently you can make up to 8,000 horsepower monsters with this pack. Oh, it's fast. I mean, I've wrecked the engine, but whoa! Oh! I could spend all day checking out the customization, but let's check out the configs. There's over 25 of them added to the pack, and this is the first one we're checking out, the GHX. It's of the Moonhawk, and it's based on the Pontiac Trans Am with that classic eagle or bird, whatever it is, on the hood. Now we've got a manual, and again, the engine sounds really nice, just slightly tweaked from the vanilla sounds. Sounds a little more raspy, and as you can see, we've got a... I don't know, that looks like a custom body kit there with the slightly cut out section for the exhaust pipes. Here we go, lights on. Oh yeah, and it's gold, trimmed in gold. I wish more cars were like this now. Ooh! And if you're a muscle car fan, this pack is a must, because I do think the muscle cars and the American cars in BeamNG, the older ones, have not been given that much love over the last few years. So if you want to see some updated configs and better engine options, this is the mod for you. We've also got a NASCAR config of the Moonhawk. It looks great. A custom skin on here, and oh yeah, turbo burger at the back. Inside we've got one bucket seat and a roll cage. So what's it like around a normal racetrack, not a big oval? Well, whoa, it revs up pretty nicely, pretty quick. So can a NASCAR actually corner? Oh, you know what, it can. Oh, it's a little bit front heavy, but it can corner. Can it drift? Here we go. Whoa. Oh, you know what? I think it can. Wow. Yes, it can actually drift. That's cool. But obviously a NASCAR car like this is best at high speed. So what kind of speed can we hold on this long straight? Well, you know, it doesn't accelerate that fast, but it seems to hold its speed quite well at the top end. And we're draining the fuel already. I've barely been driving. We've already lost like a couple of percent. Right, whoa. Here we go. Brakes. Brakes. Oh, the brakes are good. Those brakes, whoa, are good, but it likes to drift. Oh. And around the corkscrew, here we go. Brake. Whoa, drifting. Oh, it just seems a little bit too heavy. And to be fair, look at the tires. We've got slicks on here. Oh my goodness. Of course, this mod has lots of different drag configs. This is the Moonhawk Mohawk, and it has about 1,500 horsepower thanks to its twin turbos. But then over here, we've got a Gavril Barstow called the Gustav, and it's got a massive supercharger, and apparently it can do wheelies. So let's find out in a drag race. So we need to get ready and go. Quarter mile started. Can we do a wheelie? I don't think we're doing a wheelie, but it's still pretty quick. Oh, he's just about getting away. No, 108 PSI nearly. Wow. Wow, we didn't do a wheelie, did we? So we lost, but that was a pretty good effort. Okay. Whoa, the brakes. Come on. Okay, what happens if we floor it in neutral and then put it into drive? Yes, that's a little bit of a wheelie. I mean, this thing's quick, but I expected to do a bigger wheelie than that. This is quite an unusual Barstow because it's the Aero Road Sport. As you can see, it's got an Aero body package put onto it with nice sculpted lines to make it a bit more aerodynamic. But basically, it's the same as the Road Sport underneath. Now, this thing is actually supercharged, and I really like the noise of that supercharger whine, which has been just improved a little bit in this mod. Here we go. You know what? It's fast, but it doesn't feel like we're accelerating that quickly. I think the suspension's quite soft. I actually think this looks slightly better, maybe. It's more modern. Looks more 70s than 60s to me, but whoa! It does drift as well. Superchargers are pretty good for drifting, because you never get a big power burst. It's pretty constant power. And of course, they made an aero track sport, and look at these lights. The grill over them, they look nice. So what's this thing like to drive? Oh, synchronize the damage. It's pretty fast and it handles pretty well. It's not on rails, but it does seem to manage its power pretty well. We're not getting too much wheel spin when we're turning as tight as this. There you go, powering out of corners is okay. Brakes are, whoa. Okay, it's controllable when drifting, actually. It's pretty, yeah, nice. And the engine bay looks really nice thanks to these. I think these are engine braces. They look really cool. You also get a Mad Max-inspired derby car called the Serpent. This is also supercharged and sounds really nice. Now, it is incredibly powerful, so around a circle like this, you only have to give it a little bit of throttle and you accelerate away on the dirt. But, whoa, what's it like on the road? I mean, it would be pretty scary to see this thing pass you on the road, but, whoa, what's it like? Here we go. I mean, so much wheel spin. That's crazy. Well, I love that it backfires. Listen. Oh, nice. To the highway, that's probably the only place we can get enough performance out of this to test its legs. Come on, 160, can't keep it on the road. Wow, it's pretty quick. And, oh, wraps around a tree. After the crash, I've noticed that this config actually has the cargo boxes pre-installed. And then around the other side, look at where the roll cage has ended up. It's actually come out of the car. This is the Resourceful. It's a version of the Blue Buck that's basically come from a junkyard and somebody's tried to keep it going any way possible. It's really rusty. We've got odd mismatching wheels, and then under the hood, you know what? Under the hood, it doesn't look that bad. Also, in the interior, why is the interior so clean? Anyway, let's drive this thing. So apparently, this car has a cheap V6 that's been dropped into the engine bay. And I've got to say, it's not powerful. About 80 horsepower, that's it. I mean, it sounds good. That V6 sounds nice. Oh, it's so slow. I mean, first gear, and it sounds like we're thrashing it, but we're only going about 35. Now, the mod adds diesel engines to all three vehicles, and that means we get crazy configs like this, the Soot Sled. It's a diesel dragster with a pretty unique party piece. Where's this guy going? Okay, ready? We floor it, and look at all the smoke coming out of there. That is a lot of smoke. I mean, look, it's huge. There's so much smoke. But you know what? It's pretty fast, and thanks to that turbo, oh, yeah. It's really, really smooth driving experience, despite all the smoke. The steering feels very, very lazy, though. That's probably just what American cars were like. Here we go, crash test. Ooh, there goes the wheel. Wow, that was a big one. Then there's this, the Blue Buck Gasser, and I believe Gasser cars are hot rods that are designed for drag racing. Now, we've got nitrous, but I want to know, what's this thing like to drive on the road? So, whoa, it feels more grippy than the other dragsters we've already driven, and we've got a limited amount of fuel on the fuel tank, so, whoa, turning is not good. I think we expected that from a drag racer where the tires on the front are less grippy. And I love the liveries that this mod adds. They really do give some character to these vehicles. Okay, so driving along, and you have to turn quite far because of the steering angle and the lack of grip at the front, but oh, it's hard to see out the front because of that massive intake. Come on, engage nitrous. Yep, whoa, we're going. That's a big jump. Oh, bit of a wheelie. Whoa, Oh, yeah, I'm still going. Oh, carnage. I'm going to finish off with some exciting news about this mod. In the near future, we're going to get the Burnside as part of the pack. And it includes this, the fantastic Burnside Special. This is based on the fabulous Hudson Hornet. And that was a race car in the early 1950s. Of course, it inspired the vehicle from Cars, Doc Hudson. The interior is really nice in the Burnside. I really, really like it. And this car has a 164 horsepower straight six. Whoa, listen to it. It's a pretty unique sounding engine. I do like it. But what is the fantastic Burnside Special like to drive on a track? Well, first corner, we're not taking it too fast. And you know what? There's not as much body roll as I thought there would be. But yeah, so the Hudson Hornet was actually really futuristic at the time. It was like late 40s, early 50s, I think. And this body shape, it's pretty similar on the Burnside to the Hudson Hornet. I think this is a combination of a lot of 1950s cars. Oh, listen to that. It sounds really nice low down. Sounds more like a tractor, actually. But here we go. Yeah, amazing. Now, it not being so fast is absolutely fine. I mean, this was a quick vehicle back in the 1950s. I mean, it won so many stock car races. Whoa. And this is like, I think, early days of NASCAR. Oh, come on. Yeah, it could do with a little bit of a supercharger, but luckily we can add that. So there we go, we've given it a supercharger, and what's it like to drive now? Oh yeah, a lot more wheel spin. This feels better. Come on. Oh, I mean, just add so many options for you to tune up your cars. If you like to use that Control W parts menu, this, you're gonna have so much fun with this. Come on. I mean, it is faster. Superchargers don't feel like they add much power to a lot of cars, but I'm probably more used to the way turbos feel with that turbo lag and then the massive boost of acceleration. Oh, come on. Now, if you want to drive the Burnside Special, you'll have to go to, I think, Javi's Coffee or Gumroad. I'll leave a link below. You do get to pay for early access to these updated features, but they will come for free eventually to the repo version for free to everyone. So check out the mod from the link in the description. I think you'll love checking this out. I certainly did. And if you'd like to see some more BeamNG mods, click the video on screen right now. I think you'll enjoy it. Thanks so much for watching. That's all from me, and I'll see you soon for some more simulator adventures.